Morning class, our next topic is HDFS write mechanism. In the previous lectures, in the previous slides, we have seen that the data which we have to write in the HDFS file system, it should be first formed in the form of the blocks. For example, here we are having two blocks, that is the block A and block E. So first what will happen is that the client will ask to the name node that I want to store the block A in the HDFS file system. So the client node will provide a write request to the block A in the first step. In the second step, the name node what it will do is that it will start processing in the system and will ask to rest of the data nodes about that. Whichever data nodes are free, then please reply me, and it will get the IP address of the nodes which are free, which are available freely for the storage. So as in the previous lectures we have discussed about that, the HDFS file system for the failure part, it is using the replication factor. The replication factor, what does it do is that it is basically storing the data thrice. जो भी डेटा आप प्रोवाइड करें उसको वो तीन बार स्टोर करेगा, ताकि अगर कोई फेलियर हो जाए तो कोई इशू ना क्रिएट हो सके. सो वो दैट पार्ट, नेम नोड विल प्रोवाइड द थ्री डेटाज और द थ्री डेटा नोड्स आई पी एड्रेसेज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, डेटा नोड वन डेट इज डी एन वन, डेटा नोड फोर डेट इज डी एन फोर एंड डेटा नोड सिक्स डेट इज डी एन सिक्स. वो तीन एड्रेसेज जो है वो क्लाइंट नोड को देगा इन द सेकेंड स्टेप. द थर्ड स्टेप वट विल डू इज दैट द क्लाइंट नोड विल मूव ऑन डेटा टू द कोर स्विच. फ्रॉम द कोर स्विच इन द फोर्थ स्टेप द डेटा विल मूव ऑन टू द डेटा नोड वन. The client node will ask the data node 1 that are you ready, you can easily store my data or not, or having any issue or any problem. It will simply state at the time I am ready, no issues. Ready means it will definitely start storing the data. Data node 1 kya karega, us block A ko store karna shuru kar dega. Data node 1 jo hai, it will further ask to data node 4 that are you ready, are you not having any issue. Data node 4 will say no, I am not having issue. Data node 1 will say okay, if you are not having any issue, then please ask to data node 6 also that it can store the data of the block A or not. Yes, of course. 6 will also reply, yes, I'm not having an issue, I'm also ready. So all three, data node 1, data node 4 and data node 6 are ready, in ready condition, and it can easily store the data. For example, if any of the issue or any of the problem has occurred, that the data nodes is not able to, it will not come in the ready state, then the client node will again give the request to the name node that the IP addresses you had given to me, it is not properly working, it is not in the ready state, so please provide me some more IP addresses. So the name node will search for more IP addresses which are free available, and it will provide more IP addresses to the client node by which further smooth processing can be done. Fine. Now talking about the writing extension of that path, and as we have discussed that it is a pipelining fashion, we are moving our data in the pipelining fashion. The client will move on to the write request onto the DNA 1, DNA 4 and DNA 6, as these three IP addresses will provide by the name node. The first step, the second step, the core switch information will move on to the data node 1. DN 1 ke paas aapka block A chala jayega, aur jaise hi block A aapke paas wahan jayega, wo usko write karega. Write karne ke baad it will create a replica. The block A replica 1 is been created and the write request is been created, and it will move on to the data node 1, data node 4, sorry. This is my third step. आपका replica 1 कहाँ जाएगा, वो data node 4 के पास जाएगा, और जैसे ही आपका 4 के पास जाएगा, जो आपका block A है वो वहाँ पर write हो जाएगा. write होने के बाद it will generate a replica 2 and that replica will be moved on to the data node 6. That means आपका not parallelly, it is serially working. Remember that पहले आपका 1 के पास जाएगा, फिर 4 के पास जाएगा, फिर 6 के पास जाएगा. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि block A आया और तीनों के पास आपका parallelly execute हो गया. No, it will work in a serially fashion. First of all, it will move on to the data node 1, then to 4 and then to 6. And this way, the writing mechanism has been completed in the HDFS file system. I'm again defining the process. That means it will simply, what it will do is that it will simply take a block. The block, it will ask to the name node, that name node, please define me the that where have I have to store the data. Name node will provide the IP addresses that you can store the data in these DNA nodes and DN nodes, and then the DN1, DN4, DN6, all these the client will ask that are you ready in state or not. If they are ready, then it will simply transmit the data in the serially fashion. ठीक है बेटा, नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप, दैट इज एक्नॉलेजमेंट. इफ द इन्फॉर्मेशन इज बीन ट्रांसमिटेड एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू हैव द एक्नॉलेजमेंट, वी कैन नॉट कन्फर्म द डेटा इज प्रॉपरली ट्रांसमिटेड और नॉट. सो दैट पार्ट द सॉल्यूशन इज टू प्रोवाइड द एक्नॉलेजमेंट एट एवरी स्टेप. So, as the client is providing the information to DNA data node 1, data node 4 and data node 6, it will ask for the acknowledgement also. So, the client node will ask to the data nodes. The data node 6 will reply the acknowledgement टू द डेटा नोड 4 कि आई हैड रिटन द ब्लॉक ए दैट दिस इज माय स्टेप नंबर 1 इन द एक्नॉलेजमेंट पार्ट इट विल सेट दैट आई एम कंप्लीटेड आई हैड कैप्चर्ड द डेटा आई एम कॉपीड द डेटा नो इश्यूज इट विल प्रोवाइड द एक्नॉलेजमेंट टू द डीएनए 4 दैट इज इन द सेकंड स्टेप दिस एक्नॉलेजमेंट द डीएनए 4 विल ऑल्सो से येस आई हैड कॉपीड द डेटा ऑफ ब्लॉक ए नो इश्यूज नो प्रॉब्लम सो इट विल ऑल्सो रिवर्ट बैक द एक्नॉलेजमेंट दैट मीन्स इट इज हैविंग इट्स ओन एक्नॉलेजमेंट एज वेल एज द एक्नॉलेजमेंट ऑफ डेटा नोड 6 बोथ द एक्नॉलेजमेंट्स विल मूव ऑन टू डेटा नोड 1 दिस इज माई द सेकंड स्टेप इट विल मूव ऑन इन द सेकंड स्टेप the data has been provided to the data node 1 and then in the third step the data node 1 will also reply yes I had copied the data of the block A no issues no problem and it will provide further the acknowledgement of DNA 4 DN 6 and DN 1 all the three information has been provided to the core switch and through the core switch the information has been transmitted to the client node that means the acknowledgement of all the three data nodes and the client will provide the acknowledgement that my data is written successful no issues and the data is getting अपडेटेड इन द नेम नोड वहाँ पर आपका इन्फॉर्मेशन स्टोर हो जाएगी कि अब ये स्पेस जो आपके कैप्चर्ड हो गए हैं और यहाँ पर डेटा आपका अपडेट हो चुका है दिस इज द राइटिंग मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द HDFS फाइल सिस्टम रिगार्डिंग द राइटिंग एज वेल एज प्रोवाइडिंग द एक्नॉलेजमेंट नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द मल्टी ब्लॉक राइट मैकेनिज्म क्योंकि मैंने आपको बताया अभी हमने ब्लॉक ए पे काम करा है बट ऐसे कैसे काम चलेगा अभी जब मैं स्मॉल डेटा की बात कर रही हूँ मैंने दो ही ब्लॉक्स की बात करी है अगर डेटा मेरे पास बहुत ज़्यादा है तो मुझे तो बहुत लॉन्ग टाइम लग जाएगा डेटा को स्टोर करने के लिए इजंट इट ऐसा तो नहीं है पहले मैं ब्लॉक ए को स्टोर करूँगी फिर अब वो पूरा स्टोर होगा देन वी विल आई विल मूव ऑन टू ब्लॉक बी मेरा ब्लॉक बी स्टोर होगा ऐसे ब्लॉक सी होगा नो इट विल हैपन पैरेलली Now this process will happen parallelly. We have to execute parallelly all the blocks for the storage part, with by which the time will consume will less. For example, I'm having a text file example.txt and it is comprising of two blocks, block A and block B. So what the client will do is that the client will ask to the name node for the block A, whatever name node you are providing, please tell me. And for the block B also, please tell me the name. Please tell me the data nodes for where I can store my data. So the name node will provide the IP three IP addresses for the block A also, as well as the three IP addresses for the block B also. So what will happen? It will execute parallelly, isn't it? So here it is mentioned from the client 1A. To the core switch, then 2A to the switch, then from data node 1, 3A to data node 4, and then 4 to the data node 6, that is your 4A. This way, the block A will flow, start the movement of this data. Similarly, from the client 1B, that means my second block is moving, 1B, first step of the B block, then the second step of the B block to the switch, then the third step is data node 7 to the 9, that means the third B, then the fourth step, that is the B block storage, that means from the data node 9 to again to the switch MAC, and from the switch, it is moving back to the data node 3. That means the block B is stored in the data node 3 place. So this both the process will execute parallelly. Talking about this thing, it is mentioned here for block A, 1A, then 2A, then 3A, then 4A. This is the steps that how the block A will follow. For the second block B, for block B, it will move on to the 1B, then 2B, then 3B, then 4B, then 5B, and then 6B. So this 1A and 1B, it will move parallelly. Both the executions will form parallelly. It will not go serially. Aisa nahi hoga ki pehle block A aapka data dalega, fir block B dalega. No, it should execute parallelly. 1A and 1B will execute parallelly. 2A and 2B will execute parallelly. 3A and 3B will execute parallelly. Similarly, 4A and 4B will execute parallelly. So this is how the multi-block write mechanism will work. Now talking about the read mechanism of HDFS, the HDFS read architecture, it is similar to the write mechanism. अगर मुझे अब मैंने जो डेटा को स्टोर कर दिया है उसको अगर मुझे रीड करना है मुझे पढ़ना है उस डेटा को उसमें मुझे कुछ काम करना प्रोसेसिंग करनी है what I'll do is that I will simply provide a request to the name node that I want to read my block A and B and the name node will provide the IP address that where the data has been stored it will only provide a single IP address remember that it will not provide the replicas ऑफ द डेटा क्योंकि हमें रीड करना है हमें कुछ उसके बाकी के कॉपीज में हमें काम नहीं करना वी हैव टू सिंपल रीड दैट डेटा सो फॉर दैट पार्ट ओनली इट विल प्रोवाइड ओनली द सिंगल आई पी एड्रेसेस फॉर द ब्लॉक ए इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग डेटा नोड 1 फॉर द ब्लॉक बी इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग डेटा नोड 3 नाउ फ्रॉम द सेकेंड स्टेप इट विल मूव ऑन टू द इन्फॉर्मेशन टू द क्लाइंट नोड एंड देन The read information has been given to the data nodes. आपकी जो information है वो name node के through जो है अब आपके बाकी blocks के पास भी चली गई है. Then what will happen is that means from the third A step is the data node 3 will provide the information of the block A, and the data node 1 will provide the information of the block B. These are the blocks where the data has been stored for block A and B. And this information will be given to the client node. It will provide that you can read from data node 1 and data node 3. And this way how the parallel execution of the reading mechanism has been done. Thank you so much.